يتدبرون القرآن
ولو كان من عند غير الله لوجدوا فيه اختلافا كثيرا
أفلا يتدبرون القرآن ولو كان من عند غير الله لوجدوا فيه اختلافا كثيرا
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهديه الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. All thanks and praises to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I thank him and I praise him. And I seek help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and I seek refuge in him from the evil within our own selves and from our bad deeds. Whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides, no one can lead astray. And whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala misguides, no one can guide. And I bear witness that there is no one worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his final messenger. Welcome to your episode, Quran in Depth. This program is intended for us to look closely into the Quran. The best speech is the speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is a mandatory thing for each and every one of us to look closely to the Quran, to the book of Allah. The words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the miraculous words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as a final message, as a final message to mankind. There is no more prophet to be sent. And that's why this is the living miracle that every Muslim should witness. Actually, every human being should witness this last miracle from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, miracle that a person can hear it, a person can ponder over it, and we would see clearly how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protected and made this speech a miraculous speech because it's the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the previous episodes, we talked about the importance of the Quran in our life and the virtues of the Quran, the verses in the Quran, the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that talks about the virtues of the Quran and how it is important for us to take the Quran seriously. This is the thing between us and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the question that we need to ask ourselves, are we given the Quran its rights? Are we taking care of the Quran, having the nasiha and the sincere concern that this is the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that this is the thing between us and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and how are we going to hold fast to it as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered us in the Quran and as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ordered us in many ahadiths to hold fast to the Quran and to the way of the Prophet alayhi salatu wa salam, because we are not created except to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, and this is the only way that we can worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by submitting ourselves, by being Muslims, submitting ourselves to the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to the Quran and to the Sunnah, the way of the Prophet alayhi salatu wa salam. We talked about the importance of pondering over the verses of the Quran, that this is not something optional. This is the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. كِتَابٌ أَنزَلْنَاهُ إِلَيْكَ مُبَارَكٌ لِيَتَّبَّرُوا آيَاتِهِ وَلِيَتَذَكَّرَ أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ. That this is a book that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed. For what purpose? For them to ponder over it. For them to look closely into the words of Allah. For what reason? For that a person would get to know what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from him. Not what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from everybody else. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from each and every one of us. A message from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to every single person individually, so that we submit ourselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To get to this level, we need to read the Quran. We need to understand the meanings of the Quran. But we need to do, as we mentioned before, something to our hearts. We need to clean our hearts for it to be ready to accept the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if you remember the quote from Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu anhu, the companion of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, the third Khalifa, when he said, لَوْ طَهُرَتْ قُلُوبُكُمْ مَا شَبِعْتُمْ مِنْ كَلَامِ رَبِّكُمْ. If your hearts are pure, if the heart is pure, the heart is pure, then the person would never be satisfied, would say, this is enough when it comes to the words of Allah, the Qur'an. We would constantly want to know, want to recite, want to ponder over the Qur'an as a result of the hearts being clean. So it's not just that a person is sitting explaining the Qur'an and this is our work. We need to work on ourselves individually. We need to work on our hearts to clean it from all forms of impurities, from anything that is the hearts are being attached to other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anything that is of a form of a sin, disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to be constant in the state of repentance, of tawbah, that we need to be always in that state of tawbah, cleaning ourselves so that we can benefit from the Qur'an. So this program is the part that we need to know what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from us. We might get to know this by any language, but we would still miss something, miss the miraculous nature of the Qur'an, and the Qur'an was spoken by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the way that fits His Majesty subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nothing is the like of Him, but as we know, the Qur'an is in the Arabic language, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose the Arabic language for the Qur'an to be revealed and to stay like this till the Day of Judgment, to be preserved. And that's why it's something that we will talk about inshallah in the last segment of the program, the importance of the Arabic language. But before that, I would ask you to, if you have any questions, to send emails to us. We need to have the Qur'an as an interaction, something that we would learn, something that we, if we have any questions, we ask. We don't leave ourselves like this, just reciting Qur'an for the purpose of getting rewards. We need to be more serious. We need to deal with every verse. This is a miracle. This is a treasure from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And how are we going to use this treasure? How are we going to learn it? How are we going to utilize it in our lives so that every verse in the Qur'an can be a lead for us to the Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is something that we need to concentrate to understand the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And again, in this program, I would ask you to be still patient. Inshallah, next time we'll talk more about the explanations of the Qur'an. But still, some of the principles that we need to concentrate on. These are foundations. We mentioned some of these foundations so that once we start with the miraculous words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we do not have to refer back to the principles in details again. So this is very important that we set the foundation, the principles that we need to understand when it comes to the explanation of the Qur'an. We mentioned that the best way to make the tafsir and the explanation of the Qur'an is to explain the Qur'an by the Qur'an, and to explain the Qur'an by the Sunnah, by the way of the Prophet ﷺ. And we talked about that last time and how there is a relationship between the Qur'an and the Sunnah, that they are both revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When it comes to the submission, we do not differentiate between the Qur'an and the way of the Prophet ﷺ. We submit ourselves totally to the Qur'an and to the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. And the third category of how to understand the Qur'an is through the way of the companions radiallahu anhu. So there are five things actually, and this is something that Ibn Kathir rahimahullah mentioned. The Qur'an explains the Qur'an, the Sunnah explains the Qur'an, the sayings of the companions radiallahu anhum, the sayings of the tabi'een, the next generation, the second generation after the companions radiallahu anhum, and the Arabic language. Remember these five points very well, because this is our methodology in trying to explain what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from us. We talked about the first two principles. Today, inshallah, tonight, inshallah ta'ala, we'll talk about the rest and some more points as it will come, inshallah ta'ala. Why is it important for us to understand the Qur'an like the companions radiallahu anhu? You would hear in the program when we start reciting the verses of the Qur'an and trying to explain it, that we would say, قال ابن عباس رضي الله عنهما, that Ibn Abbas رضي الله عنهما said that this verse means such and such, or this word means such and such. that Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu an said such and such. These are companions of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Why is it important for us to keep mentioning their ways of explaining the Quran? Because they are the best people ever brought to mankind after the messengers of Allah. After the prophets, the level right after the prophets is the level of the companions of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praised them in the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran that He is pleased with them, they are pleased with Him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose them to be the companions of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. They took the Quran from the mouth of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam fresh. They were the first generation, the ones that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose them. And the ones that took the explanation of the Quran from the mouth of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. That's why they have the best and the most authentic way of explaining the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Especially that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam praised them. That before that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praised them. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam, the most perfect among the human beings alayhi salatu wasalam, he made dua, supplication to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhumah, his nephew, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make him comprehend this religion and make him learn the matters of the tafsir or the explanation of the Quran. When the Prophet ﷺ said, Allahumma faqihu fi al-deen wa'allimhu al-ta'wil, that oh Allah, make him comprehend the religion and make him learn the ta'wil, the tafsir, the explanation of the Quran. Also Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, the one that he said, wallahi, swearing by the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there is no verse unless I know when it was revealed, where it was revealed, and of course the explanation of it. And he said, if I know that someone knows a tafsir, an explanation of a verse that I do not know, I would travel to him to the furthest distant. This is the way that Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu said. And they had students after them, which is the tabi'een. So the explanation of the companions, the understanding of the companions of the Prophet ﷺ, the practical nature of the Qur'an, because we need to know how to interact with the Qur'an, how to learn the knowledge, and how to apply it in our times. And when we see the ways of the companions radiallahu anhum, how they applied the verses of the Qur'an, how they understood it, with the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ, and with the sayings of the ulama, this is the way for us to be able to live the Qur'an. The Prophet ﷺ, as we know from the hadith of Aisha radiallahu anha, that when she was asked about the mannerism of the Prophet ﷺ, she said, كَانَ خُلُقُهُ الْقُرْآنِ, that his mannerism was the Qur'an. The question is our mannerism is the Qur'an? Are we the Qur'an walking, meaning we're abiding by the orders of Allah? How can we do that if we do not know what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from us in the Qur'an? So forgive me for repeating this over and over again, but maybe it would get us more excited and enthusiasm that we need to get to know, so that we apply the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to have the effect in our hearts when it comes to the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the companions radiallahu anhum, how they understood the Qur'an, this is something that we would mention when it comes to the explanation of the Qur'an. And also, number four, the understanding, the sayings of the tabi'een, the students of the Sahaba. The Sahaba radiallahu anhum, they spread throughout the land, teaching the people the Qur'an and the way of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. They had students, those who learned from them, and these students, they became scholars in the religion of Islam, and they explained that to the next generation, and from one generation to the other, we have this best lineage. Till nowadays, this is the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protected it. If you look at any language throughout the face of earth, changes happens to it. The Arabic language, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protected it. If any Muslim knows Arabic, if he opens Tafsir ibn Kathir, if he opens the Qur'an and recite the Qur'an, you would see that we would understand the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this is the miraculous nature of the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the tabi'een, someone like Alqama for example, or Mujahid, that Sufyan al-Thawri rahimahullah, one of the great scholars of the early generations of Islam, he said, if you hear the tafsir, if you get to know the tafsir, the explanation of a verse from Mujahid ibn Jabr, then don't ask about it. That means you've been given enough. This is enough for you to get to know what he said. Why? Because he got it straight directly from the companions of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. So Quran explains the Quran, the Sunnah explains the Quran, the Sahaba رضي الله عنهم explains the Quran, the Tabi'een explains the Quran, and the fifth one is the Arabic language that we'll talk about inshallah ta'ala later in the program. So please don't forget these principles. This is what we would follow inshallah ta'ala, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us sincerity and to make us among those who are the people of the Quran, those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose to comprehend the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to act according to the Quran. We'll be right back inshallah ta'ala. So see you in a few minutes inshallah.
يتدبرون القرآن